Hi, today we will discuss about simple lipids. Simple lipids are esters of fatty acids with the various alcohols. Simple lipids are esters of fatty acids with the alcohol. So, simple lipid containing fatty acid and alcohol. Mainly two types are there, neutral fats and waxes. Neutral fats and waxes. Neutral fats are otherwise called as triacylglycerol or triglyceride. Triacylglycerol or triglyceride. Neutral fats are triesters of fatty acids with the glycerol. Neutral fats are triesters of fatty acids with glycerol. And waxes are esters of fatty acids with the higher monohydroxy aliphatic alcohols. Esters of fatty acids, waxes are esters of fatty acids with the higher monohydroxy aliphatic alcohol. Higher monohydroxy aliphatic alcohols. So, simple lipids are esters of fatty acids with the various alcohols. Mainly two types are there, neutral fats and waxes. Neutral fats are otherwise called as triacylglycerol or triglyceride. These are triesters of fatty acids with the glycerol. Waxes are esters of fatty acids with the higher monohydroxy aliphatic alcohols. True waxes are esters of higher fatty acids with the cetyl alcohol. True waxes are esters of higher fatty acid with the cetyl alcohol. Cetyl alcohol is C16H33OH. C16H33OH. So, two waxes are esters of higher fatty acids with the cetyl alcohol or other higher straight chain alcohols. Cholesterol esters means, cholesterol esters are esters of fatty acids with the cholesterol. Vitamin A and vitamin D esters means, these are palmitic or stearic acid esters of vitamin A or vitamin D respectively. We will see neutral fats. Neutral fats. These are triesters of fatty acids with glycerol. The type formula for a neutral fat is CH2O C double bond O R1 CHO C double bond O R2 CH2O C double bond O R3. So, the type formula for a neutral fat is CH2OC double bond R1, CHOC double bond R2, CH2OC double bond R3, in which R1, R2 and R3 represent fatty acid chains which may or may not be same. R1, R2 and R3 are fatty acid chains. This is glycerol. Next is physical properties. Physical properties. First physical property is neutral fats are colorless, odorless and tasteless substances. Neutral fats are colorless, odorless and tasteless substances. Next one is solubility. Next physical property is solubility. They are insoluble in water but soluble in organic fat solvents. Neutral fats are insoluble in water but soluble in organic fat solvents. Third one is specific gravity. Specific gravity. Specific gravity of all fats is less than 1. So all fats float in water. Next property, physical property is emulsification. Emulsification. Emulsions of fat may be made by shaking vigorously in water and by emulsifying agents such as gums, soaps and proteins which produce more stable emulsions. So these are the physical properties of neutral fats. Next is chemical properties. And chemical properties, first one is hydrolysis. First one is hydrolysis. Fats may be hydrolyzed with the superheated steam or by acids or alkalis or by specific fat splitting enzymes called lipases. So fats may be hydrolyzed with the superheated steam or by acids or alkalis or by specific enzymes such as lipases. Next we will see lipases. So these lipases are enzymes which hydrolyze a triglyceride yielding fatty acid and glycerol. Triglyceride to fatty acid and glycerol. Lipases. Lipases are enzymes which hydrolyze triglyceride to fatty acid and glycerol. Lipases are found in human body in as lingual lipase. Lingual lipase, which is present in saliva. Next is gastric lipase. Gastric lipase is present in gastric juice. Next is in pancreatic lipase, which is present in pancreatic juice. Then intestinal lipase. Intestinal lipase, which is present in intestinal epithelial cells. Then adipolytic lipase in adipose tissue. Adipolytic lipase in adipose tissue. And next one is serum lipase. So lipases are enzymes which hydrolyze a triglyceride yielding fatty acids and glycerol. Lipases are found in human body as lingual lipase in saliva, gastric lipase in gastric juice, pancreatic lipase in pancreatic juice, intestinal lipase in intestinal epithelial cells, then adipolytic lipase in adipose tissue and serum lipase. Hydrolysis of neutral fat, CH2O, C double bond O, C17, H33, CHO, C double bond O, C17, H33, CH2O, C double bond O, C17, H33. This is triolein. Upon hydrolysis, it yields glycerol plus oleic acid. CH2OH, CHOH, CH2OH, this is glycerol plus oleic acid, C17H33COOH, three molecules. So hydrolysis of triolein gives glycerol and oleic acid. Then hydrolysis of a fat by an alkali is called saponification. Hydrolysis of a salt, hydrolysis of a fat by an alkali is called saponification. The products are glycerol and the alkali salts of fatty acids, which are called soaps. Saponification is the process of hydrolysis of a fat by an alkali. The products are glycerol and alkali salts of fatty acids, which are called as soaps. So trioline plus NaOH. NaOH is alkali. Upon hydrolysis gives glycerol plus 3 molecules of sodium oleate, that is C17H33COONa, that is sodium oleate. This process called saponification, this is soap. Sodium oleate is soap. So first chemical property is hydrolysis. Next chemical property is additive reactions. Additive reactions. The unsaturated fatty acids present in neutral fat exhibits all the additive reactions. Additive reactions mean hydrogenation, halogenation, etc. Hydrogenation. Next is halogenation, etc. So, unsaturated fatty acids present in neutral fat exhibits all the additive reactions. For example, hydrogenation, halogenation, etc. Oils which are liquid at room temperature become solidified on hydrogenation. Next chemical property is oxidation. Oxidation. Fats very rich in unsaturated fatty acids such as linseed oil undergo spontaneous oxidation at the double bond, forming aldehydes, ketones, androsins, which form transparent coating on the surfaces to which the oil is applied. These are called drying oils. So, fats very rich in unsaturated fatty acids such as linseed oil undergo spontaneous oxidation at the double bond. Then forms aldehydes, ketones, and resins, which form transparent coating on the surface to which the oil is applied. These are called as drying oils and are used in the manufacturing of paints and varnishes. So the chemical property is oxidation. Next chemical property is rancidity. Rancidity. The unpleasant odor and taste developed by most natural fats on aging is referred to as rancidity. So, the unpleasant odor and taste developed by most natural fats on aging is referred to as rancidity. So, this is about chemical properties. Next, we will see identification of fats and oils. Identification of fats and oils. Sometimes it becomes necessary to identify a pure fat to assess the degree of adulteration to determine the proportions of different types of fat in a mixture. Many methods are there. First one is saponification number. Saponification number. Saponification number means the number of milligrams of KOH required to saponify the free and combined fatty acid in 1 gram of a given fat. The number of milligrams of KOH required to saponify the free and combined fatty acid in 1 gram given fat. So, the number of milligrams of KOH is required to saponify fatty acid, free and combined fatty acid in 1 gram of a given fat is called its saponification number. The amount of alkali needed to saponify a given quantity of fat depend upon the number of COH group present. Number of COH group. The amount of alkali needed to saponify a given quantity of fat depend upon the number of COH group present. Thus, fats containing short chain fatty acids will have more COH groups per gram than long chain fatty acids. And this will take up more alkali and hence will have a higher saponification number. For example, butter contains a larger proportion of short chain fatty acids such as butyric acid and caprylic acid. And it has a relatively high saponification number from 220 to 230 for butter. Butter contains a large proportion of short chain fatty acids such as butyric acid and caprylic acid. It contains short chain fatty acids. So it has a relatively high saponification number. Next is oleomargarine. Oleomargarine. It contains more long chain fatty acid. So saponification number 195 or less. Saponification number 195 or less. Next method is Richard-Mizell number. Richard-Mizell number means it is the number of milliliter of 0.1 normal alkali required to neutralize the soluble volatile fatty acid distilled from 5 gram of fat. It is the number of milliliter of 0.1 normal alkali. 0.1 normal alkali required to neutralize this soluble volatile fatty acid distilled from 5 gram of fat. This number measures the amount of volatile soluble fatty acids. By saponification of fat, then by acidification under steam distillation, the volatile soluble acids may be separated and determined quantitatively. For example, butter fat is the only common fat with a high Richard-Mizell number, and this determination helps the food chemist in detecting butter substitutes in food products. Next method is acid number. Acid number means number of milligrams of KOH required to neutralize the fatty acids in a gram of fat. Number of milligrams of KOH required to neutralize the fats in a gram of fat. It is called acid number. Acid number indicates the degree of rancidity of the given fat. Next is Polanski number. It is the number of milliliter of 0.1 normal KOH. Required to neutralize the insoluble fatty acids from 5 gram of fat. That is Polanski number. Next one is iodine number. The number of grams of iodine absorbed by 100 gram of fat. Iodine number is a measure of degree of unsaturation of a fat. The more the iodine number, the greater the degree of unsaturation. So the determination of iodine number is useful to the chemist in determining the quality of an oil or its freedom from adulteration. For example, iodine number of cottonseed oil varies from 103 to 111, and that of olive oil from 79 to 88. That of linseed oil from 175 to 202. So, olive oil which has an iodine number higher than 88, if its iodine number higher than 88, means it have been adulterated with cottonseed oil. And if in the case of linseed oil, a batch of linseed oil with the ID number less than 175. Less than 175, it also be adulterated with the cottonseed oil. That is about ID number. Next one is acetyl number. Acetyl number means number of milligrams of KOH required to neutralize the acetic acid obtained by saponification of 1 gram of fat after it has been acetylated. It is the number of milligrams of KOH required to neutralize the acetic acid obtained by saponification of 1 gram of fat after it has been acetylated. For example, castor oil, because of its high content of resinoleic acid, has a high acetyl number. Some oils with acetyl number, castor oil, it has a high content of resinoleic acid, so the acetyl number is high, 146 to 150. Next is cod liver oil. Its acetyl number is 1.1. Next one is cottonseed oil with acetyl number 21 to 25. So this acetyl number, it is used to detect adulteration. So this is about a simple lipid. Thank you for watching.